Okay, so did you know that 80% of consumer internet traffic will be video by the year 2021? Now, that's only in a couple of years. So you better start getting your video on. And the easiest, quickest, and cheapest way for you to do that is for you to do Facebook Lives. But not only do your Facebook Lives, we also want to repurpose those lives. We want to share them wherever you can. And particularly, I'm sharing them via email. So I want to show you how you can easily set up your own Facebook Live, do it, and then share it in an email so you can get even more viewers if, perhaps not everyone's seeing it on your page. So let's get to it. I want to go and do this on your business page. You can do it on your personal page, but if you want more and more traffic to interact and engage with your brand, and particularly your advertising, then you're going to want to use your business page. Yes, it's slower to get traction, but that's also why we'll be wanting to share it. And let's face it, most people want more comfortable sharing on their business page than their personal page anyway. So I always recommend going here first. So we're going to go down to the comment here, or to the publish box you can see here, and we're going to create a post. So we're going to say that we want to write what it is first. The power of Facebook Live, right? And I might even put repurposing your Facebook Live. And then we can just go and you can share it to Instagram as well if you want. I don't really need to do that, but I'm just going to go live and hopefully that narration comes up. It's going to ask, I'm on a desktop now, so it's going to ask me about accessing my camera and I'm sharing it on my business page because I've got lots of other pages there. Checking the microphone and the camera settings, all good. And I can do another title here. I won't really bother. Interactive is where people, oh, you can add a question and create a poll during your live. Oh, I could even put that there. Oh, no, that's okay. I'm not going to do that. Mess about too much. We'll just do this down and dirty quickly so you can see how to best make it happen. I've got like a little light thing like this. It's called a Luvo. You can't really see. I'm going to put the light on because everything's, and it's just like got its own little charger and you just charge it in. And you see how that just ups. I'm just in my little study nook, but I don't really want those switches. So move here. Oh no, that's not really gonna work. Okay, and the light behind me is not great either. So anyway, we'll just deal with the switches. Just trying to get those out of the frame, but I don't think that's gonna work. So anyway, all right. So then I just click go live, and you'll see my broadcast. It's gonna count it down. And here I am, just wanting to remind you of the real benefit of going live and then repurposing that live. So Facebook have started to wind back the notifications on going live. It doesn't seem to quite be getting as much kind of boost and support as it was from Facebook, maybe because more people are jumping on. It's still not too late though, and the power of video, really. By the it's been stated that by 2021, 80% of consumer internet traffic will be via video. So rather than going and paying thousands to produce your own, why not just get on and share your thoughts, your ideas, connect and engage? It doesn't have to be long. You don't have to be glammed up. You don't have to be all tricked up at all. It can be an amazingly powerful tool to connect and just share and kind of get out there. Particularly if you're working from home, it's nice to get out there on the internet. So I'm just recording this video on how to repurpose, but I will be back live shortly. Hi, Patty Ann, I'm coming back. Okay, bye. Then I click end the video. Okay, I'm going to go back on in a moment because I'd like to go on a little bit longer than that. I find that that works a bit better, just getting on, having a clear kind of topic will help you just kind of riff on it. I don't think you should script it, but I think you should have a topic, a takeaway, and a call to action in your live wherever possible. Okay, so for example, then I didn't really have a call to action because I was just showing you, but I'm going to pop on after and I'm going to talk about a certain topic, tell people how I tackled it, give them some tips for tackling the same problem if they're facing it, and then perhaps opting in for a free resource, okay? Or commenting below to receive something via Messenger bot would be good. Okay, so then I click done, and that's going to post it on to my page, hopefully. And once that happens, don't know why it seems, normally it's saying, you know, when it's available, right? It should work. So when I go down to it's not going to be there for some weird reason. Okay, once I have it on here, which, you know, all these things are always so much fun and games, right? Like, say with this one, I did it last time talking about prospect leadership, right? And then so what I wanted to do is, once it was on there and published, then I go to the post here, then I can do some different things with it. So here I can click edit post once it's, so if I haven't had a chance to write my intro, a powerful intro that piques curiosity, gets attention, because you got, like, you know, quarter of a second to get people's attention, you might want to add a title there or tags. I wouldn't really worry about it that for now. Just the beautiful thing is, what you can do is come down here and click on subtitles and captions. And then if you're English speaking, which I'm assuming if you're listening to this video you are, or you know, whatever your native language is, you can choose in the video language up here in the drop down, okay? And then you can go, you can either upload your own captions, which you can order from rev.com, or you can just use Facebook's. They're not perfect, but for lives, they're fine. Okay, so don't go to add more captions. I think there's a button that says create captions, okay? Because I've already added some. So, and we put the default language in there. I'd probably put English UK rather than this. And then I click save. After a little while, they'll upload and just automatically happen on this post. So then I have a live much like this on my page ready to go. So how do I get the link to share it? Well, what I do is I go to the date or the time, okay, that should be sitting right here. And then I just pop that in there. I'm getting my cable TV installed, so if you hear the drilling in the background, that's what that is. So once that's here, I'm just going to pause that. There's the drilling. Then I'm going to see up here, I'm going to highlight this URL. I'm going to copy it. And then I can just put that in to my it's my Infusionsoft, but it's your email autoresponder service. Okay, you might have you know, Get Response or ConvertKit or whatever. I have Infusionsoft, so then I'd log in and do all that stuff, and then I can work through that. Okay, so that's really how simple it is, step by step, to create your live and share it. You can also share that on other social media too and say, hey, just went live. Put that on your personal page. If you want it on your personal page, actually, you can just, if you want it within Facebook, you can just share that there. So you can share it, I believe, only to a page. I didn't think you could share it to a group. So maybe, can I share? So if I share this, I can, share to a page or a group. So I can do it to a group, I can share in an event, and I can share on my own timeline, which is my personal profile. Okay, so I just click that and press post, and away we go. All right, so no excuses, it's time to get your video on.